This is the newest addition to Skin for Life. This is our portable oxygen infusion system. This little unit gives you the ability of using our four Skin for Life Pure Science oxygen infusion gel, along with delivering the phase two of the oxygen infusion activator. Let me show you how this machine works. You have your insert for your airbrush gun right in front of the machine. And you also have the advantage of adding on the hand pieces of the LED light hand pieces of red and blue. So that gives you a little bit more of an addition. So the actual plugs go in the back of the machine, and you can fit those in the back. And you do have two ports, so you can use the blue and the red together. Or what I recommend for most estheticians is they get an additional red hand piece so that you can work the face easy and more effectively by using the two hand pieces together. And this way, an esthetician or a beauty therapist can save time. So once the unit is hooked up, you also have a little carrier for the oxygen gun. So when you're using this unit, you want to first apply one of the oxygen infusion treatment gels. We have brightening, which has kojic acid, licorice, and bearberry. This is great for all pigmentation purposes, whether it's melasma, chloasma, solar lentigines, anything that has a hyperpigmentation value where you want to even the color of the skin. The sensitive that we have has chamomile, visible, and it is very good for desensitizing the skin. So the sensitive can be on anyone with stage one rosacea, stage two, any type of capillary distension as far as sensitivity, very good after professional peel system, or anything as an exfoliation where the skin is left a little red so that you can infuse the oxygen and also desensitize. The A, C, and E of our formulation is for mature skin. Skin that might have fine lines, wrinkles. It gives a triple antioxidant, so it really helps to build up blood circulation and excite the skin. And then our antibacterial has our ingredient lysozyme. Our lysozyme helps to prevent, reduce, minimize oxidation to the follicle wall, so therefore it's helping to accelerate more oxygenation, where it reduces the amount of inflammation to an acne skin. It can be an active acne where it's inflamed, or non-inflamed just due to oily skin condition. Our activator actually goes into the cup of the airbrush gun. The activator is a very unique product because it interacts with your skin enzymes within your stratum corneum. So it's a chemistry response that literally delivers this type of formulation, and your enzymes become the workforce. They become the activity to break down the formulation into your skin's pure oxygen. So you have that ability of the stratum corneum to not only be oxygenated, but also very well hydrated. What I thought today I would do is demonstrate the oxygen infusion aesthetic portable system. So I'm going to select the brightening for her particular skin, because you can see that she does have a little bit of a darker skin, and that we want to make sure that she maintains an even complexion. So I'm going to start pouring it into the glass bowl, and you want to use at least a good 7 mL to completely cover the skin. The biggest part of using the infusion gels, whether you're using brightening, AC&E, sensitive, or antibacterial, you want to make sure that the gel is very thick. So medium thickness is needed in order to cover the complete skin. Want to do the nose. You can go under the eye, not to the lash line, but underneath the fatty part of the eye. And you can see my application is a medium thickness because it ends to be a very shiny mask look to the skin. Now what you generally want to do is after your exfoliation, after your toning of the skin, completely dry the skin, apply the application of the oxygen infusion gel. Either gel is perfectly fine depending on the condition of the skin. And what you want to do is manipulate. So whether you do certain massage movements, to really excite the stratum corneum, to really excite the skin. And you can do vigorous movements to lift, because this treatment also helps with toning the skin. Once you create that oxygen, it's not just, you know, creating the oxygen and that's all you get. You really want to cause a lifting and a toning effect of the skin. So once you do this for a minute, no more than 2 minutes, then you want to apply your activator, which is your phase 2. Now this is going to be applied in the cup of the gun. So you want to lift the lid and apply about a half of the cup. And put your lid right on top of it, snap it in place. Remember, with the airbrush gun, you must push down and pull back in order to disperse the liquid from the front end of the nozzle. I'm going to turn on the unit, push back. Start with a circular movement as you apply the liquid. And then as you apply it, you want to take your other hand and manipulate it, so that the skin has an interaction with the product. And you want to do at least a good 3 to 4 passes to really excite the skin so that the enzymes within the stratum corneum can do a full breakdown of the formulation in order to create your skin's pure oxygen and extra hydration. And again, this is for demonstration so you can understand the application of the product. Go around the nose. And what's very unique about this product is that not only are you creating oxygenation, but you're also detoxifying the skin by eliminating whatever waste byproduct the skin has been saturated with. So it really helps on a lymphatic standpoint to stimulate the whole process of not only blood, but lymph. And once you complete the application of the oxygen, you want to again manipulate the skin where you are performing effleurage, petrissage, depotement movements for at least 1 to 2 minutes and really excite the skin, because again, you really want to create toning capabilities of the skin and really brighten the skin and create more capillaries to deliver more nutrients, water, and oxygen. So the whole cell metabolic rate is increased with the application of product. So once you've completed your massage movements, so now what we want to do is just remove everything. I've removed the majority, and I'm just making sure that everything is removed thoroughly. But from the beginning to now, you can see where the skin is a lot whiter. It's a lot more alive. You have more circulation. So remember what this side looks like in turn, compared to this side where it's just a little bit more yellow and it needs a little bit more microcirculation. So from this side that wasn't treated to this side that's a lot more vibrant, it's a lot more tone and it's a lot more lifted. So she's very young to begin with, which is a beautiful thing, but we still have fun at that age and we can have a little bit more yellow and a little bit of lack of elasticity, where this side is definitely a lot firmer and a lot brighter. This particular treatment can go after, you can perform this treatment after your exfoliations. And just know that not only can you do the face, you can do the neck, you can do the décolleté, you can do arms, you can do pedicures with it, you can do back treatments. It's a great lifting treatment for pigment. You can isolate and perform this treatment on acne and any type of sensitivity within reason, because again, this is an oxygenation treatment. So with capillary distension, with stage one rosacea, anything that is drastically sensitized, you need to use caution. But with the AC&E for mature skin, you have the triple of the antioxidant, so it's very microcirculating, it's very toning to the skin, and they get a nice little tight lift to their skin as well. So after you perform the oxygen infusion treatment, now you must maintain your airbrush gun. It is very important that you maintain your airbrush gun, because once you purchase this particular unit, you do not want to void your warranty because of poor maintenance. So with your airbrush gun, just like with anything you do after your treatment, you must clean up. So by cleaning your airbrush gun, we do have an O2 cleaner that has saponin, so it's like a foamy substance. And you want to lift the lid off the gun. And you do not have to put a lot, but you do have to at least use 1/4 of the cup size of the liquid in the gun. And this is the most important part. Before I start, I want to show you. You want to take a piece of gauze or paper towel or a towel, and literally your gun is, the tip of your gun is going to touch the gauze and you're going to go in circular movements. The reason for this is because you want to dislodge anything around the needle that might impair the gun for emitting the solution. Spray by pushing down and pulling back and going in circular movements until all the liquid is gone. Over, and all the liquid is gone. This doesn't take a long time to perform the cleaning procedure. However, you must do it after every treatment. So therefore, the gun is not going to be impaired during your treatment, and you'll always have a good performance application of the oxygen infusion activator with every treatment process. Once you've completed cleaning the gun with the O2 cleaner, then you want to put the same amount of water just from the faucet, tap water, where it's 1/4 full in the cap of the gun. Put your lid over the gun and press tight to clip it. You're going to perform the same procedure that you did with your O2 cleaner. Whereas you're going to take a piece of gauze, fold it into a 2x2, or you can use a paper towel or a towel, and use the tip of the gun on the gauze in circular movements so that you can make sure that everything from the cleaner and any kind of residual is out of the gun cap. And making sure that everything is dislodged from the needle. So as you can see, this process will take you 30 seconds to a minute long to perform. Again, this needs to be a part of your cleanup after every treatment. Thank you for choosing Skin for Life, your all-in-one solution for equipment and professional skin care. If you have additional questions, please contact Director of Education Frieda Mills or visit skinforlife.com for additional training support.